A Boeing 737 passenger jet crashing off Indonesia.
This was one of the darkest days in Boeing's history. 189 people were killed 13 minutes after Lion Air Flight 610 took off from Jakarta. Just 6 months later, a second crash occurred 6 minutes after Ethiopian Airlines 302 took off from Addis Ababa, killing all 157 passengers.
Tout le monde essaye de le joindre sur son téléphone portable, aucune réponse.
Both flights had been operating the same plane, the new Boeing 737 MAX jet, built to rival Airbus's A320neo. Countries around the world rushed to ground the aircraft.
President Trump tonight and his emergency order grounding all Boeing 737 MAX 8s and 9s here in the U.S.
The Federal Aviation Administration was one of the last to do so.
We need to know if Boeing and the FAA rushed to certify the MAX.
As questions began swirling about what had caused the crash, whistleblowers began coming forward.
When I mention that I've seen operations in the military shut down for lesser safety concerns, I will never forget his response, which was, "The military isn't a profit-making organization."
A whistleblower at Boeing also revealed to the New York Times that defective parts were being used in new aircraft.
Three of my inspectors jumped up and said, "No, you cannot do that. That's a serious process violation." And he basically told them the same thing, "Don't worry about it."
An investigation led by the House Committee on Transportation and Infrastructure would reveal the Federal Aviation Administration had delegated many of their safety checks to Boeing as the manufacturer raced against Airbus to get the aircraft certified. That rush led to a major design oversight and to both crashes. But this is not the first time the FAA has been called out.
Joseph Monfort, a former Army helicopter pilot and FAA employee since 2009, now says he was prevented from inspecting the aircraft prior to the crash.
The inspector general says the FAA and Southwest are not following federal guidelines, putting more than 17 million people at risk.
Most recently, an engine burst into flames on a Boeing 777. Similar incidents have occurred over the last 3 years.
In 2018, a cracked fan blade on another United 777 caused the engine to come apart. Last December, it happened on a Japan Airlines 777. 3 years ago, a passenger on a Southwest 737 was killed.
Ground it no more. The Boeing 737 MAX set to take flight in the U.S. again tomorrow.
Now, following a 20-month review process, the MAX jet has been certified to take to the skies once more. The chief of the FAA, Steve Dixon, took to the cockpit himself in a bid to boost confidence in the aircraft.
I completed a number of test profiles today to examine the functionality of the aircraft, and I liked what I saw.
But with the investigation into the crashes revealing instances of the FAA putting profits before safety, and Boeing being fined $2.5 billion for fraud and conspiracy in relation to the crashes, many are questioning if the FAA and the Boeing MAX jet can be trusted again. It takes an average of 8 to 14 years to design, build, test, and certify an aircraft. 154. The 737 MAX is a new version of the 737, a plane that first hit the airways in the 1960s. And is to date the most successful aircraft in history, accounting for more than half of the roughly 20,000 aircrafts ever sold by Boeing, contributing trillions of dollars to the U.S. and global economy.
And man steps across the threshold into a bright new age.
The design upgrade on the 737 MAX made it 12% more fuel efficient than the Airbus Neo.
Airbus came out with a new generation of their very successful A320 aircraft. So Boeing made the decision to put off the plans for the new airliner and to modify the 737.
A lot of people criticize Boeing on the MAX because it was about the sixth major stretch, if you will, or modification of that airframe. Everything was driven to keep costs down, increase the number of passengers, improve fuel efficiencies.
The Boeing-Airbus rivalry is over 100 years in the making.
Our product strategy is to have the most capable airplane in every segment of the commercial airplane market.
Boeing quickly became the leading provider for commercial and military aircraft in the U.S. and around the world. 50 years later, a European rival was born in France. Airbus grew fast and became a major contender. They remained close competitors until Boeing's sales took a dive in 2019, following the crashes and the grounding of the MAX jet around the world.
Today was about telling them we're sorry. Wanted to share with them our commitment to safety.
Several investigations pointed to MCAS as the culprit, a piece of software meant to stop the plane's nose from pitching upwards and prevent the aircraft from stalling. However, Boeing failed to alert the FAA about this important update and the additional costly pilot training it would require. The plane stalled and hurtled to the ground.
Boeing decided that the best way to compete was going to be to continuing on with the Boeing 737 line. They had a lot of customers that would like that.
During MCAS activation,
new MCAS computer system was mentioned only once.
The MCAS could have activated because of a failure of the angle of attack.
They had to stick these larger fan jets underneath the wing of this 737, which is pretty low to the ground to start with. So what Boeing said is, aha, we can come up with a piece of software and it will automatically shove the nose down if the pilots allow the nose to get too high. Well, for reasons that are still not clear, they didn't fully explain this to their customers, the airlines, and they didn't fully brief the pilots who would be flying the new MAXs on this new piece of automation.
But MCAS is only a symptom of a greater problem.
The Joint Authorities Technical Review was an effort started by the Federal Aviation after the two tragic crashes of the 737 MAX.
The Joint Technical Review, an independent body that was formed to scrutinize how a plane that is so meticulously constructed failed. One glaring issue has been the inability of the FAA and its 40,000 plus employees to keep up with high-tech advancements that were being made at Boeing.
Time and money play a role in this, but time and money have always played a role in the design of airplanes. My question is, what's new and what's changed is the increasing complexity and interconnectedness of aviation systems.
Because new technology is so complicated that even within a manufacturer, you only have a few people that are going to understand a particular system. If you try to bring in a person from the outside to figure it out, it's just overwhelming.
What happened in this situation of the 787 and the 737 MAX was that the private industry, particularly Boeing in this case, felt that the certification process was too onerous and too slow for them to be competitive in the market that was developing with Airbus.
Technology is only half the story. Boeing has successfully lobbied the FAA to take on most of its own oversight and won.
Large corporations in the United States exert extreme amount of power on the political system. Boeing is a case in point where they were increasingly given more autonomy and self-regulation.
So far, the cost of grounding the MAX has reached $20.7 billion. As of now, Boeing is one of the biggest lobbying machines in Washington, coming in at 10th after major spenders like Big Pharma, with $12.6 million spent to shape government policy in 2020 alone. And it's no wonder, the U.S. government spends billions purchasing aircrafts from Boeing each year, one of the largest companies in America, with over 140,000 employees.
Money talks, okay? And Boeing had a lot of money, and they can influence politicians, and of course, it came back to bite them and will ultimately cause billions of dollars to recover. So Boeing was able to lobby for an increased amount of delegation so that their own employees would act as inspectors.
Both of these accidents were entirely preventable. We cannot fathom the pain experienced by the families of those 346 human beings who were lost.
Il avait 38 ans, il allait en avoir 39, il allait se marier 4 mois après. Comment je vais pouvoir passer les 40 ou les 50 prochaines années de ma vie sans lui?
The CEO of Boeing had begged the president not to ground the 737, and we knew there was real interference there, and we were the last to act. That is what really shook our credibility around the world and put all of us in jeopardy.
All of those planes are grounded, effective immediately.
I think it's the right call.
To err on the side of safety is what people have been calling for days.
But Boeing and the FAA's relationship does not stop there. With only a finite amount of qualified engineers, people that have worked at Boeing will often work at the FAA, and vice versa, creating a revolving door that may be compromising oversight.
The problem with the United States government is the fact that they can't pay for the talent that they get. Private industry pays substantially more, so trying to attract the best and the brightest into these positions is going to take some work on the part of the FAA.
Our specialists have scrutinized the A380's design right down to the smallest component.
The European Aviation Safety Agency, the FAA's European counterpart, has also recently recertified the MAX for flight. On their website, they wrote, "This assessment was carried out in full independence of Boeing or the Federal Aviation Administration, and without any economic or political pressure."
This aircraft now has been scrutinized in every which way but straight. And now it's probably the safest airplane flying out there.
And that's the catch-22 in this whole certification battle, if you will, is you've got to have the resources, both people and money, so that you can have your independent people in there looking at the process and not getting in the way of the process, but just observing, studying it, understanding it.
A top safety expert at the FAA has also recently spoken out against the recertification of the MAX jet, saying additional system upgrades were still needed. In this race to the top, Boeing's financial drive and the successful removal of government oversight have left families scarred for life. Congress has recently passed a bill that will be sent to the Senate asking to reform the FAA with the express intent of strengthening its certification process.
Really need to see this is passed through Congress and given as a priority to Secretary Buttigieg and Administrator Dixon. We owe that to the families of the 346 lives lost and the way that the entire world views U.S. aviation.
Well, I think it would be a really nice thing to see the FAA hire people from outside the United States, people that were trained at other manufacturers in different cultures, because they would have a different perspective.
Boeing, qui construit un avion aveuglé par le profit de son entreprise, fait courir le risque à 346 personnes. Et dans cet avion, il y a des gens qui illuminent et qui éclairent le monde parce qu'ils se rendent à une conférence des Nations Unies sur le développement durable. Il n'y avait que des gens comme ça. Quand est-ce que l'être humain va enfin avoir le courage de se regarder en face et de se dire « ça fonctionne pas comme ça, ça fonctionne pas comme ça ».